everyone. Hope you all are doing well. So previously I have discussed about some terminologies, or you can say some definitions of the chapter genetics, right? So if you did not watch till now, just go to the playlist which is genetics and you will get it. So from today's class, I will discuss about another terminologies which is you need to be understood to know or to clarify the concept of the overall chapter. Okay, so let's start. Firstly, here I will discuss about pure hybrid. What is pure? What is hybrid? What is trait? Okay, so what is atavism? And the last one is what is lethal gene. So first I am going to start with what is pure and what is hybrid. So firstly, from the name, I think we can understand some particular thing or some particular idea. That is, pure means there are no mixture, right? Such as pure milk, okay, pure food. So there are no other food additives, right? Or there are no other external chemical in the food. So that is why we are using the word that is pure. So here the pure is used in the genetics. In that case, pure means there are no mixture of alleles. The particular trait or the particular no trait. Let me discuss about trait and then I will tell you about the trait. So firstly, what is pure? Pure means the characteristics which is not mixture of two types of characteristics. Let me tell you first. Yesterday I have discussed about the definition of allele and also what is dominant allele and what is recessive allele. So here the pure means there are no mixture of the alleles. What is that? Capital T, capital T. In case of, suppose here is a chromosome, the homologous chromosomes, and in one chromosome capital T is present, in the another chromosome also capital T is present, and the T is responsible for the characteristics which is tall. So this is pure organism, because a particular characteristics, that is the height of the plant, which is encoded by the particular gene which is dominant allele in this case. So here the capital T, capital T, when the phenotypic characteristics of the or the phenotype of the plant should be tall, right? So here the capital T, capital T is pure, because here both of the alleles are dominant in nature. None of the allele is recessive, or rather we must say there are no mixture of allele. So this is pure plant, pure tall plant. Okay, in the other case, if we can draw another two chromosomes, and here is small t, small t. So small t is the recessive allele, right, which is responsible for the dwarf characteristics or dwarf height of the plant. So here also it is pure dwarf plant, that is small t, small t. So if a plant have capital T, capital T in their particular gene which is responsible for the height of the plant, then the plant should be tall. In the other hand, if the plant have the small t for the height of the gene, or sorry, the height of the plant, then it should be dwarf in nature, right? So this is basically pure trait. There are no mixture of alleles, no mixture of dominant allele and recessive allele, only pure is present. In the other hand, when the cross occurs between two particular pure plant, then it will create the hybrid nature of plant, or it will create the hybrid height of plant, we can say. So is it hybrid or not, we need to know about the genotype. Previously I have already explained about the genotype terminology. So you need first to see the previous videos. Okay, so here hybrid means the crosses between pure, and also the genotype of the hybrid should be the mixture of dominant and recessive two. Okay, so here is the dominant and recessive. So the phenotype of the plant is capital T. The phenotype of the plant is, the genotype is capital T small t. So the phenotype is also tall, but due to the presence of capital T, the dominant allele, and recessive allele which is small t, we need to tell it hybrid plant. Okay, is it clear? We will discuss about the Mendelian's experiment, and then we will get the final explanation or elaboration. Okay, so next I am going to discuss what is trait. It's very simple. Already I think you have already known about it. So what is trait? Suppose your characteristics which I have seen, okay, your particular characteristics which is observable and also controlled by your genes, that is known as trait in biology, or it is regulated by the genes and also by the environment, and moreover it is regulated by both environment and genes. Okay, so trait basically the characteristics of a particular organism. Okay, suppose in case of mammals, there are presence of diaphragm, or they have mammary gland, which is trait of human, which is genetically controlled, and sometimes it is environmentally controlled. Clear? So this is trait. The next is, I think it was lethargy. Okay, no, atavism. So what is atavism? Basically atavism came from a Latin word that is atavus. Okay, atavus. So it means ancestor. Okay, your great 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 grandmother, or your great 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 grandfather. Okay, so what is atavism? Basically it is a particular characteristics, we can say, when it is atavism, when the reappearance of a particular characteristics which is in the newborn baby after skipping some generation. Let me tell you elaborately. Basically suppose a particular human being, okay, so we don't have tail after birth, we don't have tail, proper tail we don't have, right? So basically as we all knew about it, our ancestor is monkey. So monkeys have tail, right? So suppose after generation, then the reappearance of the tail will happen to a particular newborn baby, then it should be known as atavism. So after skipping generation after generation, the particular characteristics reoccurs to a new generation. then it is known as atavism. Okay, so there are many examples, right? So basically, some scientists also discovered some teeth in chick embryo. So chick means from birds, right? They are birds. So there are the reappearance of teeth in the birds. How? After skipping generation after generation, that means from the reptiles to birds, as evolutionary aspect, from the reptiles they have teeth. After generation, then there are, we can see, or they can see, that reappearance of teeth on chicken embryo. So this is the example of atavism. Also, leg appears in the dolphins. This is also example of atavism. Okay, so the last is lethal gene. So lethal means fatal or death. So particular gene, suppose, which is present in a chromosome, which helps in the development or in the growth of a particular organism, also it is fatal. That means the presence of that particular gene is responsible for the death of an organism. If it is present, then the death which is confirmed for that particular organism. So it is done basically due to some mutation in the DNA, and it is happened in the heterozygous dominant or the homozygous dominant or the homozygous recessive condition. It can be happen in the dominant allele, it can be happen in the recessive allele. Okay, so there are no possibilities or there are no surety about the presence of lethal gene. Okay, let me tell about one thing I have forgotten, that is what are the causes of atavism. Why does atavism occur? Because due to some mutation in the DNA, due to sudden changes in the DNA. We will discuss elaborately about mutation, which is very very important, we can say method, or we can say evolutionary causes, that is very much helpful for us and also for every organism. Not only helpful, it can be helpful or can be harmful too. Okay, so atavism, what are the causes of atavism? Basically the changes in the DNA, or sometimes due to some environmental changes, due to some environmental aspect, the nature selects this particular reappearance of characteristics which have already gone. Again, it appears, right? So this is all about today's lecture. Hope you will like it, and definitely let me summarize today's video. So firstly, I discussed about the pure organism, hybrid organism, and then lethal gene or lethal allele, atavism and trait. So just read it from your book, from your any book. I think the concept will be cleared as crystal. Okay, so stay tuned, and definitely please support my channel. And also, if you have some request about biology, about study tips, about study blog, just give me, just drop a comment in the comment box. And also, stay happy always, and take care of yourself, your family. Till then, bye-bye.